On our show, I love to chat to people. Oh, you've noticed. I meet the good people sometimes who live and work in the Northeast, especially those who make a difference. And we've spoken to the Reverend Jim Craig before, but I noticed he was celebrating 10 years as the arts chaplain in Gateshead, right? I thought, let's get him back on the show, find out more about the man. I asked Jim how he ended up here in the Northeast doing this job.
I did my training in Durham at Cranmer Hall at Vicar School, which is a little bit like Hogwarts, but without all the robes. And the diocese that supports you generally has first dibs on where you go. So they sent me to Stanley for 2.5 years, to St Andrew's Church there, and I had 2.5 years there as curate. And then this job came up. And the second I heard about it, I was like, ooh, arts chaplain.
I like that.
That's a gym job, that is. And
a
so,
gym
a gym job, if I'm sure that'll come into common parlance soon.
I like that expression, a gym job. Yeah.
Definitely a me-shaped job. I thought, arts. And the reason is my theology degree, my kind of vicar school degree, which you have to do for your vicar training, it was my second degree. So I have 2 degrees, which I'm very proud of.
No one likes a show off.
I struggled through them both. I'm not a natural academic. But the first one was fine art in Hull 20 years ago. And so to go back to art and mix the first part of my academic life, art, it was the only thing I was ever good at, and the second part, the vicar bit and the faith bit, was like, ooh, this is, I've got to go for this.
What was it that brought you to the church? You know, had faith always been a huge part of your life?
No, there was a kind of Sunday school legacy, like you have a lot of people my age were probably sent to Sunday school to get them out of the house.
Oh, I was.
Yeah. And so there was a sense of the church was there, and but it was a story you learnt about rather than something you were really challenged to believe. It was just, oh, let's learn about this bloke called Jesus who was around ages ago, but it's got no relevance on your life. And then the penny dropped at art college, really, meeting a really fantastic bunch of people who just seemed to make it real, really. And it helped that I was a misery guts, so I was kind of...
You were not
I was a misery guts.
Well, yeah.
I had no self-confidence and no friends, and just, yeah, university was a real struggle, so the nicest people I met were Christians, which is like, oh, do I have to hang out with Christians? They're all kind of, you know, rainbow guitars and sandals. It was, but I thought, hang on, why judge them? Just because every Christian you've met before has been a bit kind of wet. And now I am one. And yet, very quickly I realised how kind of judgmental I was being.
But this kind of, yeah, this image of sort of happy clappers.
Oh, yeah.
It's not the case now, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe it is.
No, largely not. But it still sticks in your head. It sticks in my head. And I kind of expect, this sounds terrible, I do apologise to friends and colleagues. But when I meet new Christians, I'm instantly thinking some of them to be a bit like that. And when they're not, I'm like, oh, relief. Yeah. Normal person, full of passion for
Jesus.
And
then when they meet you, I suppose they relax a little bit because they find out, actually, we don't have to be stuffy about this.
Yeah.
You know, you're quite a fresh, forward-thinking type of chap, aren't you?
I think that's the reason why I'm wearing Hieronymus Bosch Dr. Martens, because people tend to look at them and think, he must be all right, he's got fantastic
boots. Yeah, here
on.
He is with his dog collar. And some Doc Martens.
Yeah.
It's a trendy vicar.
I'm a hipster vicar.
Let's talk some more after two to the Reverend. Celebrating a decade as arts chaplain on Tyneside, the Reverend Jim Craig is a dedicated and very interesting bloke. He popped in this morning. We had a good chat. How did you end up being an arts chaplain? And For that matter, what is one, please?
I don't know, really.
Was it a position that was created for you?
No, the job was created through a sort of three-way conversation between clergy in Gateshead, Bensham, two parishes, and the then Bishop of Jarrow, John Pritchard, and that conversation had been sparked by the presence of Baltic, which by then had been open a few years. Sage was about to open, and we just happened to have a spare vicarage in Gateshead and a lot of imagination. So they thought, oh, spare vicarage, imagination. And should we be involved in this conversation about the arts? So let's get an arts chaplain in And there was such a thing as arts chaplains at that point, a chap called Canon Bill Hall, who retired about 5 or 6 years ago. He'd set up the arts chaplaincy, which was conjointly sponsored by all the northern dioceses, Durham, Newcastle, York. And they thought, oh, we like what he's done, but we need to, rather than just supporting artists and theatres and actors, which is what Bill was doing, we want to encourage people to be creative and bridge the gap between those who think, oh, yeah, the Sage is nice, the Baltic's nice, but it's nothing to do with me, it's a bit la-di-da.
Well, exactly. I was just going to say that, you know, arts chaplain. So arts, you know, people might think, no, it does nothing for me, you know.
It sounds
installations
a bit,
and weird. Yeah. How do you go about breaking that down and making people not shy away from it? You know, arts and religion, you know, it's a heavy sell for a lot of people, perhaps. Do you know what I mean?
I think you're absolutely right. At the beginning, I tried to separate them. So the religion was me, and that's me obviously being sent from the church into the community, wearing my dog collar, so it's obvious where I'm from and why I'm doing it and my motivation, which meant I didn't really have to say anything because people generally go, you're young for a vicar. Why are you in the church? So straight away you've got an opportunity without ramming it down everyone's throats to say something
just to tell
honest.
Them.
And they're the person who's invited you in to say something. So the arts was always something that was offered to people as a fun alternative to an existing meeting that they already have. And the first issue I had was getting people in Gateshead to kind of come to things at a specific time. So I might say, I'm doing this next Tuesday. Why don't you come along? And I discovered that very few people keep diaries. And there's loads of lovely people who are retired or some are retired who are dedicated to their families and have lots of commitments. Mm. So it was hard to get them along, but it was much easier.
So how did you get them along then?
I didn't. I went to them. So I discovered that there was a bingo group on a Monday in church and they would never come along to something, even if it was free, and what I would think in my head was an exciting opportunity. So I went along to them, played bingo for a while, and said, actually, next week or a couple of weeks' time, would you allow me to bring some canvases and we'll do some painting?
Oh, I love that. I love the fact that you've done that, you know.
Yeah, and that generally went down well. They were used to having parties for the friends. I think the first arts project I did, they said, oh, it's so-and-so's birthday that day. Can we bring a bottle of Prosecco in? And yeah, so we made it a party. And that released a lot of tension of, I can't do this.
This is BBC Newcastle. Sanctuary Arts Spaces in Gateshead. Did you actually set that up?
Yep.
Yeah. Because some people, you know, I'm sure, might think it's a strange notion, art gallery in a church.
Well, if you think back to, if you went back 500 years in time, you'd find virtually all the churches in the country painted with frescoes and murals.
True.
A bit like the stained glass, just telling the story of Christ and his saints in a visual way, which I think we all appreciate.
Do you get people coming along, though, Jim, who aren't religious?
So
you don't have to be religious to come along?
That's kind of my whole message, really.
Right.
I get people who approach me very apologetically and say, I'm not religious, but can I come in? It's a building. It's a public building. It's not just
You can't really turn them away, can you? No, I'm sorry, you can't.
Yeah. Well, I think churches are places surrounded by a mystique of protocols. So people imagine, ooh, how do I enter this building correctly without annoying someone? And the funniest thing I find is when people go, sorry. And I think, well, gosh, have I got the power to make someone feel embarrassed because they've said a very, very, very minor word like damn.
Because they've said God.
Yeah. God. And I think...
Does that annoy you when people... Because they call it blasphemous, don't they?
No.
God, I've just done that wrong.
The first thing I want to do is put people at ease and say, look, I'm sure you didn't mean it as a kind of indictment.
No, no, it's crept into our parlance, hasn't it? It's not a bad thing.
Yeah. I think my entire message is God wants you as you are, so don't worry about bringing your Sunday best into church. Be yourself. And that's a message that people in church still need to hear because they often keep a lot of their questions and issues about their own faith quiet because it feels embarrassing. So.
Other stuff that you do, you've got an open mic night for musicians that you have in a local coffee shop, I think, don't you?
Yeah, that's probably our most recent collaboration between a fantastic new independent shop on the high street called Altin Coffee. And they're a stop at the Job Centre, a collaboration with the Academy of Music and Sound, which is opposite them on the High Street, who are an independent music academy doing degree courses and everything from GCSE music upwards, BTEC, etc. And so at the minute we're relying on their musicians, their students, to kind of get things started. But the idea is, you know, well, it's like a busker's night. Everyone's welcome.
Get in there.
So that's every Thursday between 6 and 9, and we're inviting people to come at 6 to kind of sign up. But everyone's welcome, and we're there tomorrow night after a little break for Easter.
I started a conversation yesterday on the show with a man called Jim Craig. He's a reverend, right? But get this, he's celebrating 10 years as something called the Arts Chaplain in Gateshead. He told us he doesn't want to be seen as an unapproachable vicar. So he goes out and about. He gets in your way and makes you kind of like sit up and take notice. Not in a bad way, in a really cool way. He provides people with places that they can share their talents. Today he tells us about all sorts. Here's a vicar that does the whole social media thing, right? This is what happened. You are a trendy vicar.
I am. I do try.
How many vicars go on Facebook these days?
There's quite a few, actually.
Really?
Yeah, there's quite a few. Yeah, there's quite a lot of connected vicars. And we've had a few social media engagement workshops run by the diocese. So they're obviously recognising that this is where people are at.
Of course it is. What's your Facebook?
What is my Facebook? That's a good point.
Trendy. So, I think if you... Trendy Jim... /
Well, I've got two pages. My personal page, which is a great embarrassment to the diocese, is Stripping Vicar.
Right, so, yes, I've heard about the Stripping Vicar.
That needs a bit of explanation at a later date. And my Sanctuary Art Space page is just Sanctuary... I think it's facebook.com/sanctuaryspace. Which has been going for a while
now. Do you do Twitter and Instagram and everything?
I'm on Twitter. On Twitter, I have a very Sunday best name because Jim Craig was taken, so I've gone for James O.M. Craig, which sounds like an author, doesn't it? James O.M. Craig.
Doesn't it?
I was looking for respectability because that's something I struggle with.
On Facebook, you're a Stripping Vicar and you say you struggle for... You struggle for what? Are you a man that likes to be at one with nature? Is that why you're Stripping Vicar on the Facebook there,
no,
Jim?
No, I was... I think I had my kind of tabloid hat on when I set up the page and I thought, oh, I might get noticed if I'm Stripping Vicar. But that was all down to the fact that my first engagement with Radio Newcastle was following my very brief appearance naked down the quayside for the Spencer Tunics Naked City event, which was it was only kind of 3 hours at a very respectable time.
We weren't like, completely naked.
We were indeed.
Completely.
1,700 of us completely naked, completely buff.
Can't you get into trouble? You're not allowed to parade around naked,
well,
are you?
Apparently, you're not allowed. This is true. There's an ancient medieval law that says you're not allowed to walk over the swing bridge naked. I think we might have been allowed. We were allowed over the Millennium Bridge naked, but not the swing bridge. So the odd thing
no
was
no swinging.
No swinging. So the odd thing was to get over it. This is true. To get over it, we all had to put on for the time it took us across slippers. Or was it flip-flops? And those kind of rain macks you get at festivals.
Oh, right, yes.
And then took them off again just across the bridge because of this daft medieval law. But everything else, for the 3 hours it took to do all these shoots...
Did you build up your part as you crossed the bridge?
Yeah, absolutely.
I guess all these things you do, it's all about... Goes back to what you said before. It's all about connecting with people,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
It's all about making that connection and get people to think, oh, actually, I quite like the look of this or the sound of it, you know.
It's about levelling the playing field and getting, you know, trying to knock down boundaries. And as you said at the beginning, art sounds a bit la-di-da.
Yeah. Many people switch off, don't they? You say art or installation. It's like, oh, no, that's not for me. That's for posh people.
Yeah, and I think art's important to me because when I was younger, I was incredibly shy up until the age of about 16, which people find hard to understand now.
Well, you said it before.
I can kind of go around the quayside naked.
I can't shut you up now.
But yeah, you can't shut me up. But I was very shy. So art was the only thing I had to express myself for a long, long time.
So this is the Reverend Jim Craig celebrating 10 years now as arts chaplain in Gateshead. Final part of my chat with a most entertaining and interesting man. I like talking to interesting people. I hope you don't hear them on the show when we do it as well. He's a vicar. He's an arts chaplain. He's no ordinary vicar. His name is the Reverend Jim Craig. He's a firm believer in getting out there, spreading the word, engaging people as best he can. We've heard about his love of art. We've heard about him getting his kit off on the quayside. And now an in-depth look into his TV career. You starred alongside your ponytail in the popular series A Touch of Frost, didn't you?
Oh, gosh, yeah. Have you picked that up?
We know everything.
Gosh, this is my heathen days before God came along and made me respectable. I had a friend who starred in a YTV children's programme for a year or two, and then he went straight into production and sort of
what program
behind
was
the scenes.
It?
I can't remember what it was. No. This is going back about 30 years.
Right.
And so he said, oh, we need some extras for this brand new, I think it was the first season of Touch of Frost. And all you have to do is sit in this pub and for an afternoon and be filmed. And I thought, that sounds great. Do we get, for it to be authentic, do we get drink?
I bet you didn't.
I was quite partial to that. Well, we all got
shandy.
A drink.
Oh,
and I was the only one, I'm ashamed to say, who, after that was finished, went back and said, look, for authenticity, I should have a full one, really, rather than just putting this empty bottle to my lips. So I had two bottles of, I think it was probably pills at the time.
But you didn't want to be an actor?
I didn't then.
No.
Gosh, if I was offered the opportunity now, I'd take it like a shot.
Would you?
I'd become a wee bit of an extrovert. But and that's the thing about childhood. You're offered things at school, like starring in a play, that gives you, even if it doesn't give you a career, it gives you confidence. And I would love to go back and do these things that my kids are offered, which I kind of shrank from. So I was like, oh, that sounds terrifying. And now I feel like, under supervision and wisdom, I'm kind of reliving my childhood.
You're
trying things out.
You're a huge music fan as well, aren't you? What sort of stuff will we find in your collection if we were to rifle through it?
Oh, gosh. I've been listening to a lot of retro stuff recently. I've had Leeds band Wedding Present on my,
have
in
you?
My car for ages.
Cause God, you are a trendy vet, aren't you?
My favourite album was Bizarro, which was around 1990, and had the hit song Kennedy, and it's such a great song to kind of just unwind to when you've done a funeral, perhaps, and you've got a 10-minute journey in the car, and you want something that's kind of, just too kind of... Well, I do anyway. Maybe not everyone wants that, or a bit of Led Zeppelin.
Bit of Led Zeppelin there as well.
Captain Beefheart's been on the...
Captain Beefheart.
Yeah, yeah,
what do you think about
album.
Modern music from the charts?
I quite like the kind of electro stuff.
Right.
I like kind of bleepy, kind of abstract music.
Mm-hmm.
I like a bit of pop, a bit of Kylie. Anything that just kind of sets you free.
Bit of Hot
really,
Chip, yeah. Maybe?
Oh, yes,
Hot
yes,
Chip.
Yes, Hot Chip. I've
very
got
good.
Their first couple of albums, Made in
very
the Dark and that kind of stuff.
Congratulations on this 10 years here. What will the next decade hold for you? Will you still be here in 10 years' time?
Gosh.
Or will you move on, Reverend Jim Craig?
I've stopped worrying about it, really. Because when I arrived, I was given a five-year contract, and somehow that's lasted 10 years. Through the grace of God and some really supportive colleagues and a really supportive parish. I absolutely love Gateshead. So despite every now and again you see something like a job in the Church Times, which sounds about as exciting as it is, you see a job that catches your eye and think, no!
It won't be as good as being arts chaplain in Gateshead.
Exactly. Canny people.
It's not going to be beaten. Congratulations, seriously. And
cheers.
Nice to see you again. My favourite vicar ever.